in Mulva Hill. This week my husband Bill and I are working on a project in our vegetable garden. I'm standing between our two raised beds that are filled with veggies we want to grow through the fall and winter months, but they obviously will need more protection from the weather. So we're building a hoop house, which is a greenhouse covered with plastic. Stay tuned.
Our hoop house dimensions are 10 feet wide by 9 feet long. We wanted to make it sturdy yet lightweight so it can be moved to different areas of our vegetable garden as we rotate our crops each year. We used 2x4s for the base and Schedule 40 PVC electrical conduit in 10-foot lengths. See how each conduit has a straight end and a flared end? That way you can put together two pieces of conduit to make each hoop. Bill pre-drilled screw holes into the non-flared ends of the conduit so we could easily attach them to the 2x4 base. We pre-marked the inside of the 2x4s every 20 inches for the spacing of the hoops. Next, we put the two pieces of conduit together to form a hoop, then screw them into place on the 2x4s. It was pretty cool to get the first hoop up. Pretty soon, we had the second, third, and fourth hoops up with a goal of 6 hoops. In addition, we added an extra hoop on the first and sixth hoops as they would become the front and back walls. Bill made an upright support for the center of the back wall and attached a metal conduit at the peak for more structural support. He used black plastic zip ties to attach it to the highest point of each hoop. Here you can see how the structure is coming together. We purchased 10-foot wide 6mm greenhouse plastic to cover the hoop house and used aluminum clips to attach the plastic to each hoop. Bill added 2 lengths of metal conduit to the top of each side of the hoop house to provide more support. He attached them with zip ties as well. Next up was putting the plastic on the front in preparation for hanging the door. Once the door was in place, we put plastic on the back wall. And there you have it. I'm really excited to see how it works this winter and will keep you posted on my blog. For more detailed information about this project, visit susansinthegarden.blogspot.com.